Welcome to Turn the Page. My name is Monique Snyder, Communications Manager at Wicomico Public Libraries. Our first guest today is Dave Hanlon. Mr. Hanlon is a committee member for the Salisbury Book Drive. Welcome, Dave.
Hi, Monique. Nice to be here.
So tell us about the Salisbury Book Drive.
Well, the Book Drive is part of the Salisbury Book Festival, which is mm-hmm. being held this spring. The Book Drive is going to kick off April 20th at the Light on Literacy Breakfast that the library is organizing, and it will run through May 20th. The idea is to redistribute books around the community.
That's wonderful. And so how can community members donate?
Well, they obviously we want books.
Yeah.
Gently used books would be great. New books would be great, mm-hmm. especially if someone's going to buy books. We really like to have them buy children's books, mm-hmm. Young children's books, birth to five, elementary school, even puzzles would be great. And if someone doesn't really want to go to the effort of buying books or going through their garage or attic and finding books, we'll take cash. People who are interested in donating money can donate it to the library with a note on the check that it's for the community book drive. And we will use those books to go out and buy books for children under five who's primarily at home speak Spanish or Creole, French. Mm-hmm. We want to be able to get books into the hands of children in their native language.
Excellent. So the books will be collected at the library. And are there any other places around Salisbury that one can donate books to, or is it just a library
that's actually, during place? That period of time, we're going to have over 20, 25 drop sites around the county. Churches, businesses, not-for-profit organizations mm-hmm. have all stepped up and said, you can put a book drop, we'll put it up here in public so people can drop books in. Like I said, there's about 20 or 25, or they can always write a check to the library. The list of places will be available. They're still being developed. It's mm-hmm. not being finalized. But there's a poster that will be out in a couple of weeks that will list all the possible donation sites.
Great, and we'll make sure to have that on our website and all of our social media pages.
Everyone's been very supportive. That'd be great.
So who will be receiving these books primarily?
Well, the intent is that these books, well, obviously, there's going to be some adult books that will come in. We'll find a good home for them. There's mm-hmm. lots of need for books of all kinds. The elementary schools will be receiving some of the books, better condition. And then we'll be using lots of not-for-profits. We'll be distributing to lots of not-for-profit organizations around the county. Wherever there are young children, we want to be able to get books into their hands, make them available, be it in the waiting room of a doctor's office, but primarily not-for-profits like Head Start which would be Shore Up, or some other pre-K programs around the county.
And we know the books are very expensive. If you go into Barnes & Noble, you know, they're $20+, so not every child has the opportunity to have access to this type of material.
Absolutely.
So I think this is a wonderful cause. So what do you hope to accomplish by collecting all these books and distributing them?
We really have four goals. First of all, we want to spread the news that we love books, we love mm-hmm. reading, and to celebrate that fact. Too often young children don't maybe pick up that message. We want to give new life to books that are sitting in attics and garages around the county. We want to draw attention to the Salisbury Book Festival. It's a great opportunity to celebrate reading, and we want people to come downtown and want people to be part of it. This is a way for people to participate. And the fourth goal is that Wicomico County, we need to do a better job of getting our youngest children ready for kindergarten. Right now, all kindergartners are assessed when they arrive at school, and we're not doing a very good job, especially in language and literacy skills. And we think if we begin to draw attention to it, we can begin to put resources out into the community, maybe we can do something about moving that bar and getting our children ready to learn.
I know this is a personal mission for you. You've done it in the past. So what takes you to be so invested in this cause?
Wow. I guess I've been involved with the whole issue of early childhood development for about 8 years now, starting back in Washington County where we used to live. And this is just a natural extension of the way in which when we were engaged in that issue, we found out that people, businesses, not-for-profits needed to have resources. And so we said, well, let's get books. And the idea came up that there were a lot of books that are maldistributed. We need to get in the hands of people that will benefit from them.
And could you share a little bit about the impact of reading and literacy in a child's life?
Wow. Yeah, Well, reading, there's a whole bunch of reasons why. Young children, we talk about language skills, word recognition, knowing that us, ands, thes, es, ifs, that all go into a kindergarten. Kindergarten's recognition of word walls, wall words, basic communication skills. It also strengthens the brain, which is a foundation for a broader range of learning, especially certain structures in the brain that are developed from reading. Social skills. A child sitting with an adult or another child can interact with that individual, and as they talk about what they've read, can just do tremendous, develop other skills for in other areas called social-emotional skills. Elementary schools, it opens minds to new possibilities. Nonfiction imparts new facts. And fiction helps individuals expand their imagination and develop empathy for others. Think about that, empathy for others, empathy for characters, and of course for adults to have fun.
Thank you so much for being here and sharing all this wonderful news. We look forward to seeing more about the book drive and just spreading the word of literacy, because we at the library sing its praises, but we love to see other people sing its praises as well.
Very good, thank you, Monique.
You're welcome. We'll be back in a few moments. Welcome back to Turn the Page. Our next guest is Valerie Murphy. Valerie is a friend of Wicomico Public Libraries and sits on the committee for Light of Literacy Awards Ceremony. Welcome, Valerie.
Thank you.
So tell us a little bit about the 2017 Light of Literacy Awards Ceremony.
Okay. This is actually our fifth annual Light of Literacy Awards. And the awards were started to highlight the unsung heroes in our community that were bringing literacy to people in the community that wouldn't necessarily have access to it. And so the awards will focus on different categories and highlight those people.
Is there a particular focus for this year's award ceremony?
Yeah, so normally people think of literacy as just being reading and teaching people how to read. But in actuality, literacy is just teaching other people a skill or a talent, and it doesn't necessarily have to be reading. So this year, our focus is going to be financial literacy. And in fact, we will have our comptroller of the state of Maryland, Peter Franchot, will be coming to give the keynote speech. and highlight a little bit more about the things that we can do to help the financial literacy in our community.
And that's exciting because that's a huge keynote.
Absolutely.
Speaker,
we're very excited about it.
Yeah, we'll welcome him with open arms because we know he has a lot to say about literacy and just things that you might not necessarily associate with literacy,
exactly.
Like you mentioned, financial literacy.
Exactly.
And other types of literacy that we would highlight, like health literacy, computer literacy. Mm-hmm. I mean, it doesn't, like you said, it doesn't stop at reading.
It does not stop at reading. There's, like you mentioned, the health. And but in fact, there was a previous year where Reverend Hutchinson was nominated for his community garden. So he was teaching children how to garden and sustain a gardening community, which was very important as well, too. And so that is also a form of literacy.
Of course. Mm-hmm. So this year, if for those who haven't attended, mm-hmm. you know, in the previous years,
right.
What types of awards will you be giving out?
So the awards that we give out, we have one for an adult luminary, so somebody that's working as an adult in our community. It doesn't have to only benefit adults, but the nominee has to be an adult. We also have a youth award, and that is for anybody that's the age of 18 and younger in our community. We have an educator award, so that's somebody that's working in either the school system or anybody that deals with education for 18 and below. And then we have a higher education award. And so that's either a student or a professor in the university environment or college environment. We also have a business award that highlights our local, or doesn't have to be a local business, it could be a national business that has a local presence, and the work that they do to support literacy in our community. And then we also have a nonprofit award. And that highlights those nonprofit businesses or services that are doing more than what they would normally do to help members of our community. Now, in addition to all of that, we actually have our Liz Bellavance Memorial Award, and that is something that we just started last year to highlight somebody that kind of lives up to Liz's legacy, because she was very passionate about helping people in the community in many different areas, and she was always kind of looking out for the little guy, somebody that wasn't paid attention to, somebody that she could kind of bring out into the mainstream and help them acclimate to the mainstream. And so our Liz Bellavance Memorial Award highlights somebody that has worked on achieving literacy for their entire career or for a very long time in many different ways. And that's not something that we give out every year. We look at our nominees mm-hmm. and see if someone's deserving of that award.
So I know we've had a lot of outstanding winners mm-hmm. over the past few years of all different age groups, of all different organizations. Is there one that stands out to you? And can you tell us a little bit about why they won?
Yeah, I can actually tell you two of them. I had mentioned Reverend Hutchinson earlier, which I really loved that story because of the gardening connection. But we also had a company called PLB Comics that won a few years ago. And what I really liked about them is they were bringing a new form of literacy in graphic artistry, in comic book artistry, and they would come out and actually teach children how to draw, how to put their stories on paper, and tell a story, not necessarily a comic book, but, you know, graphic art, which is more than just comics. And that was very exciting, and they were so excited to get the award, and that was just kind of nice to see. And in addition, we had Neil Jen, who was a Chinese immigrant who came out and realized again that there was a need in his community, in the immigrant community, not just for English as a second language, but for understanding the culture of America and acclimating to the culture of America, something that English as a second language courses didn't just, you know, give to you. They try a little bit more now, but he really saw that need and pushed it even further and included Chinese immigrants as well as other Asian immigrants to try to teach them a little bit more about what it meant to live in this community. And I just thought that those were, again, not your typical literacies, but something that was definitely sorely needed in our community.
Of course. I know Mr. Jen would help people fill out their doctor's forms
exactly.
or take them to immigration.
Mm-hmm.
Like you said,
the entire experience, not just English.
Yeah.
So that was very helpful to all of those and something that was very much appreciated by the entire community.
So tickets are on sale now.
They are.
Where can I get a ticket for Light of Literacy?
You can get a ticket at any library branch, as well as online at lightofliteracy.org. And you can also contact the library. You can call 410, and I'm going to look up the number because I know I'm going to get it wrong, 749-3612, and it's extension 141. And our award ceremony is going to be on April 20th at the Wicomico Civic Center in the Midway Room. And it's from 8 to 10 and in the morning.
That includes a hot breakfast?
That includes a hot breakfast. And as we already mentioned, Peter Franchot. And as I mentioned earlier, that this is sponsored by the Friends of Wicomico Library. And we'll also give you a chance to come out and see what the Friends do, because our mission is to support all library programming and expand library programming in ways that the library itself maybe cannot. And so we're just an extender for them. And you can help us celebrate all of these fabulous award winners who, as I said earlier, are unsung heroes. And the biggest thing that I take away from this award ceremony is at the end, so many people say to me, I didn't know anybody was doing that. I didn't know anyone did that. I had no idea this was going on. And to me, that's the most rewarding portion of the event, is not just the award winners, but all of the nominees, to see what goes on in our community that we are not aware of. And actually, our nomination deadline was yesterday, but we are still looking for nominees. So if anybody could get those nominees on back at that website, we'll still accept them for the next few days.
And tickets are $20?
Tickets are $20.
Very affordable?
Very affordable, because like you said, they include the breakfast.
We look forward to the whole ceremony and seeing the winners and nominees, and just really celebrating literacy.
Absolutely.
In our community.
Absolutely.
Thank you so much for
Thank
being
you.
Here, Valerie. Stay tuned. We'll be back after a few messages. Welcome back to Turn the Page. Our next guest is Tim McRoberts. He's the Chief Public Service Officer at Wicomico Public Libraries. Welcome, Tim.
Hi, Monique. Thanks for having me.
Of course. Right. So tell us about Salisbury Reads.
Well, Salisbury Reads is a program that the library and the city has initiated together. Actually, Mayor Jake Day requested the library to come up with the Salisbury Reads program. It's modeled on the state of Maryland's Maryland One Book program that was so popular last summer. So we're doing the same thing here in Salisbury.
That's exciting.
Yes, it is.
So tell us a little bit about the book that was chosen for Salisbury Reads.
The book we selected is called The Underground Railroad. It's written by Colson Whitehead, has several awards under its belt, a National Book Award for Fiction, Goodreads Review Fiction winner, not to mention the Carnegie Award winner, and it's on Oprah's 2.0 book list. So it's a pretty popular novel, and basically what it's about is a runaway slave who gets on the underground railroad to escape. But there's a twist. The Underground Railroad is actually a train, and it takes her to different states and cities around the country in different time periods. So it kind of puts together the experiences of being a slave back in the middle 1800s mm-hmm. with our current country sagas and ills that are going on today.
So this is modeled after One Maryland, One Book, which a library has done in the past.
Yes.
It's typically in the fall.
Yes.
This will be held in May?
It will be held in May. It is going to go for the whole month of May.
Okay. And where could I get a book?
We're going to have these books available at all the library branches, mm-hmm. in the downtown branch, the center branch, the Pittsville branch. You'll be able to come in and pick up the books there.
And is there a cost? Do I have to purchase the book, or?
There will be no cost for the books. You can come in and get them for free.
We like free at the library.
We like free at the library.
So as a community member, how could I participate in the Salisbury Reads
program?
Yeah, program.
Well, what we'll do is once you come in and get the book, we'll have some reader guides available. The whole idea behind this program is to get the community involved in developing their own book discussion groups with their churches, places of worship, work, other types of groups that people have when they get together. You could use those as a model to get your book discussion groups together. The reader guide will help guide you with discussions and questions that you can further develop your book discussion about. But really what it's all about is trying to come together as a community and get everybody to understand the differences between everybody and what we can do to move forward as a community.
And this is a very timely book as far as what's happening in our society.
It is very timely. The experiences that the slaves, the characters in the book experience are very similar to what's going on in today's America.
And we want to thank the Community Foundation of the Eastern Shore because they helped us a
lot.
Yes,
big time, with a wonderful grant that is going to help us buy these books so we can give them away free to the community.
So shout out to them.
Shout out to them. Big time. Yep. Community Foundation.
So all through May, books are free. Come to the library to pick up a book.
Yep.
And that's at either one of our branches.
Any branch.
Okay, downtown, Pittsville,
or
Center Branch Library.
Yep.
We are really excited for this program.
Yes, we are. We're looking forward to it, and it's tying in with a lot of other happenings that the library and the community are all involved in together, yeah. So it's going to be a great month.
We talked a little bit about the Salisbury Book Drive with Mr. Hanlon earlier,
mm-hmm.
and that's kind of under the umbrella of the Salisbury Book Festival.
Yes.
There's a
yes.
5K run with
yep.
the Board of Education in April. We have our Light of Literacy Awards ceremony.
Yep. Reading in the Zoo.
Yeah.
Is all happening. The Salisbury University Children's Literacy Festival is happening in April. So it's pretty much April-May combination with a bunch of literacy type programming and events that are happening in our community. And we're all wonderfully happy to be part of it.
And then kind of to round everything off, we have the Book Lovin' Block Party.
Then we have the Book Lovin' Block Party, which is going to happen on May 20th, 2017. It's a Saturday. And that's going to kind of be the capper to all these literacy events. And the book festival is going to have a focus on one book that changed a life. You know, one book that could change your life. So it's a focus on how important literacy is, especially for young children and families, to help those young children develop good and proper reading skills.
And all of this information will be on our website, wicomicolibrary.org.
Yes.
We'll have it on our social media pages. I'm sure some of our community partners will be sharing that information as well.
Yes.
So as soon as it comes out, we'll kind of blast it to the community.
Once it comes out, it's going to come out in force. Everybody, we have a lot of community partners, a lot of people that are involved in all these programs. So we're all going to be helping each other and promoting and marketing and getting the word out for all the events that are coming up from April through May.
That is exciting.
Yes, it is.
And we're looking forward to it.
So are we, very much.
Thank you so much for being here, Tim.
Thank you, Monique.
Thank you for tuning in to Turn the Page. If you have questions about anything that you've seen or heard today, please visit our website at wicomicolibrary.org. Or visit one of our library branches. We have three of them, Downtown Library, Pittsville, and Center Branch.